I don't know what storm you're in today in your life, but this I know, you are not alone.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah. You are not alone. You got a God who walks with you. You got a God who fights for you. Yes. You got a God who carries you. And you got a God who sees you through. You are never alone. Yes. Somebody needs to know that they are never alone.
Thank you, God.
Yes, yes.
And as we prepare to leave this day and go into tomorrow, we should walk with the power of this truth.
Yes. Yes.
We should go into Monday knowing that God is with you.
Yes.
And because of that, you got the strength. Mm-hmm. You got the victory. You've got peace. You are not alone. Yes, you may feel weary. Mm-hmm. You may feel abandoned. Mm. You may feel like no one understands what you're going through, but that's a lie from the pit of the bottom of hell. You are not alone. How do you know that God who spoke the stars into the existence, the God who breathed life into our soul, the God that has promised that he is with you and he will never leave you nor forsake you. So when the enemy comes at you, when fear tries to creep in on you, when you feel like you're at the end of your rope and there's no hope, just say that I'm not alone. My God is with me.
Thank
I feel
Lord.
The spirit of the Lord, because this is just not a nice idea. This is a promise. God said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. God is not a man that he should lie. And if God said it, I believe it. I can stand on it. You can stand on it. You can walk on it. You can rest in it, because you are not alone. No veil in hell. No storm in life. No valley. No sickness. No sorrow. No loneliness can separate you from the love of God. Hallelujah. You are covered by his blood. You are protected by his love. You are carried and you are love. So I need us all for just a moment. I need us to grab hold of this truth deep down in our spirit. Let me tell you, child of God, you are not alone. Somebody needs to know that they are not alone. When we leave, we need to walk out with our head held high, knowing that the creator of the universe is walking with you. Every step of the way, God is with us through every mountain, every valley, every storm. Open your Bibles with me to the book of Isaiah. And as we go to that particular book, we will go to chapter number 41. And let me welcome all of those who have prayed for us, prayed with us. And let me welcome those who have shared with us financially in their gifts and tithe and offering and all these other things that people do and just bless us in so many ways so we might bless others as well.
Amen.
That's Isaiah, the 41st chapter, and we're going to start with verse number 10. And you're going to see these words are something very similar. Fear not, for I am with you.
Mm-hmm.
Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand.
All right.
Fear not, for I am with you.
Thank you, God.
Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you.
Mm-hmm.
I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. And finally, fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you.
Mm-hmm.
I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. And this morning, I want to preach from the subject, you are not alone.
All right.
You are not alone.
Amen.
There are some who may believe they're alone due to many and or several reasons.
Mm-hmm.
And those reasons can vary. It could be maybe a life event, loss of a loved one, divorce, retirement, job change, moving to a new area, or maybe becoming a parent. We might have those who feel lonely due to maybe social isolation. If you remember a couple of years ago when we suffered up under the COVID-19 pandemic, there are a lot of people who didn't get opportunity to see people. be around them or experience people. They had their social interactions limited. Some might feel lonely because of maybe a lack of close friends. Mm-hmm. Used to be the life of the party. And now all of a sudden, maybe because of lifestyle changes and growing older, you don't have those same social interactions anymore. Maybe you don't hang around your family like you used to. Mm-hmm. Maybe you are living in an environment where people can't get to you. You move so far out that people don't come out to see you as much.
Yeah.
That's it.
There are those who might feel alone because of mental health conditions.
Yeah. Yeah.
We know how important mental health is in our society, especially right now, as most of us know at least one person who, if they haven't told you, you might feel and or believe that they have a mental condition.
Mm-hmm.
Depression.
Yeah.
Anxiety, which can make it really difficult for us to reach out to others.
Yeah, yeah.
And in doing so, make it difficult for others to reach out to us. There are those of us who might have low self-esteem, feeling unworthy of connections or believing that we are not good enough for meaningful relationships.
All right.
We stay to ourselves. We bury ourselves in our work, our books, our hobbies, and we just tune out the rest of the world. There are some of those who have social anxieties for fear of social situations, making it hard to build connections because of past relationships that broke your heart, disappointed you, made you feel as though you can't trust anyone anymore. There are those who suffer from lack of emotional intimacy. We feel as though people just don't get us. We can't be that difficult. People don't understand us, and people don't take the time to understand us. And in doing so, we quit trying to get people to understand us.
Yeah, yeah.
We don't have that deeply connected feeling with others. We see people who have grown up as kindergarten friends, people who have had the same friends all their life, and we don't have that connection, and for some reason we feel like maybe it's us.
Yeah, yeah.
There are those who might feel alone because of their personality traits. I know that there are many people who love to follow their astrological horoscope signs, and maybe your horoscope is one of those who say that you are a loner, or you might not like being around a lot of people, or you're introverted. Well, someone may prefer smaller groups or smaller social circles.
Yeah.
But still, even in the midst of that, you experience loneliness.
Yeah.
There are some of us who feel that we're alone because of maybe discrimination. You might live in an environment where you might be the only one of your race in that environment.
Mm-hmm.
You might be the only one. You might be in an environment where you might be the only one in a different financial category than those you're around. And for some reason, you feel discriminated against.
Yeah, yeah.
And then there are those who have physical limitations that keep them from wanting to let people see them when they feel like they might not be at their best.
Yeah, yeah.
You might have been in a car accident. You might be in a hospital. You might be in a home. You might be having some type of care, and you just don't want people to see you when you're not at your strength.
Mm-hmm.
You want people to remember you the way you used to be.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that, you have caused yourself to maybe feel like you are all alone. I do believe that somebody who is listening to this message today needs to hear this word, that you are not alone.
All right, all right. Mm-hmm.
You may believe that you have the weight of the world on your shoulders. You've been fighting battles that no one else even know about. You might have been fighting battles that no one could even comprehend that you are even in that match.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes it feels like you're fighting all by yourself. But I came to tell you this morning, you are not alone. And my first point is this: God walks with you.
Mm. Yes.
God walks with you. And I want to remind us all that God walks with us from the moment we wake up, from the time we lay our heads down, even in our weakest moment and our greatest victory, the Lord is with us.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
I read this morning from Isaiah 41:10, and it basically tells us that fear not, for I am with you. And I love the fact that he said that in an affirmative, I am with you. He didn't say, I might be with you. I'll show up when you get yourself together. But God said, I am with you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
And that tells me that God is with us through every tear.
Yes.
Every fear.
Yes.
Every trial, yes, God walks with you.
Yes.
You may have people who come and go. You may have friends who leave. You may have loved ones who have turned their back, but God is constant companion, and we are not alone. Now, next point is God fights for you.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes.
God fights for you. Because if you've lived long enough, we all know that life is a battle. There are some of us who might even be able to witness that. Mm-hmm. That you wake up expecting a battle. Mm-hmm. You're expecting someone to go against you. You're expecting someone to call you out on something you didn't do. You're expecting to fight just for your life. Mm-hmm. And the enemy will throw everything he's got at you. The enemy will try to wear you down. The enemy will try to give you fear.
Yes.
Discourage you. Mm-hmm. And isolate you so that he may attack you. Mm. But let me tell you, you have a God who don't just stand with you.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
But we have a God who will fight for you.
Yes, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
The Bible tells us, when Moses and the Israelites stood at the Red Sea with Pharaoh's army bearing down on them, it looked hopeless.
Yes.
But God said, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord.
Yes, Lord, yes.
And what did God do? God parted the sea and they walked through on dry land.
Yes.
God didn't just stand by and watch.
Yeah.
God stepped in and made a way.
Yes.
Somebody knows that God will fight for you.
Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
He will fight for you. He will walk with you.
Mm-hmm.
He will fight for you.
Yes.
And God will carry you.
That's it.
Do you know that there are times in life that we might get so weak that we can't even take a step?
Mm.
We might get so weak that we can't even throw a punch back at our enemies. And that's when God carries us.
Thank you.
Yes, yes. Thank you.
There are times in our life when the battle gets so tough, you don't even have the strength to fight. And I know I'm not the only one who has been in that situation before.
Mm-hmm.
Where you just threw up your hand and said, you know what? I don't even care anymore.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever. And that's when God will come and pick us up. Turn us around, plant our feet on a solid ground.
Yes.
That's the kind of God that we serve.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
When we can't even get a prayer out, when all things we can do is just sweep throughout the night, not even knowing if morning will come.
Yes, yes.
If joy will be there in the morning.
Yes, yes.
We find it hard to even just hold on to God's unchanging hand. And that, my friend, is when God will carry us.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
So God don't just walk with you. God just don't fight for you.
Uh-huh.
God carries you. He lifts us up when we can't go on. Isaiah 41 and 10, go back to it. It says, I will strengthen you and help you.
Mm-hmm.
He said he will uphold us with his righteous right hand.
Yeah.
So he don't even need his left. He can hold us up with just his right hand.
That's it. That's it.
And when God holds us, no devil in hell can pull us out of his hand.
That's it. That's
he said,
it.
I will never leave you nor forsake you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
God will see us through.
Yes.
That's my next point. God will see us through.
There we go.
You may be going through the storms of life right now. You may feel the weight of trials, the heaviness of life pressing down on you. But I need you to know that this storm won't last always.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
We serve a God who sees you through the storm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Who walks with you through the storm, through the valley.
Yes.
The same God who was with Shadrach, Meshach, yes. and Abednego yes. in the fire. Yes. The same God who's with Daniel God. In the lion's den.
Thank
that
Lord.
Same God is with you today. And he will see you through.
That's it. That's it.
Man.
I don't know what you're facing today in your life. I don't know what storm you're in today in your life. But this I know. You are not alone.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
You are not alone. You got a God who walks with you. You got a God who fights for you.
Yes.
You got a God who carries you. And you got a God who sees you through. You are never alone.
Oh, yes.
Somebody needs to know that they are never alone.
Thank you, God.
Yes, yes.
And as we prepare to leave this day and go into tomorrow, we should walk with the power of this
yes.
truth.
Yes, yes.
We should
yes.
go into Monday knowing that God is with you.
Yes.
And because of that, you got the strength.
Mm-hmm.
You
yes.
got the victory. You got peace. You are not alone. Yes, you may feel weary.
Mm-hmm.
You may feel abandoned.
Mm.
You may feel like no one understands what you're going through, but that's a lie from the pit of the bottom of hell. You are not alone. How do you know that God who spoke the stars into the existence, the God who breathed life into our soul, the God that has promised that he is with you and he will never leave you nor forsake you. So when the enemy comes at you, when fear tries to creep in on you, when you feel like you're at the end of your rope and there's no hope, just say that I'm not alone. My God is with me.
Thank
I feel
Lord.
The spirit of the Lord because this is just not a nice idea. This is a promise. God said,
Jesus.
I will never leave
Lord.
You
yes.
nor forsake you. God is not a man that he should lie. And if God said it, I believe it.
Yes.
I can stand on it. You can stand on it. You can walk on it. You can rest in it because you are not alone.
Yes.
No devil in hell.
Uh-huh.
No storm in life.
Yes.
No valley. No sickness. No sorrow. No loneliness can separate you from the love of God.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. You are covered by the blood.
Yes.
You are protected
Jesus.
By his love. You are carried and you are love. So I need us all for just a moment. I need us to grab hold of this truth deep down in our spirit. Let me tell you, child of God, you are not alone. Somebody needs to know that they are not alone.
Yes,
when we
Lord.
Leave, we need to walk out with our head held high, knowing that
Lord.
The creator of the universe is walking with you
mm-hmm.
every step of the way. God is with us through every mountain,
yes.
every valley,
Thank
every
you.
Storm.
Mm-hmm.
God is
yes.
with you. I don't
Thank
care what
you.
It looks
Thank
like.
You.
I don't care what it feels like. When the enemy comes against you,
mm-hmm.
trying to whisper these lies,
yeah.
telling you you're not enough,
mm-hmm.
telling you it's too hard,
mm-hmm.
telling you to give up, telling you to stand, you need to just stand firm and say, I know my God
yes.
is with me.
Yes,
it may not look like it, I might not feel it, but I know God is with me.
Amen.
No weapon formed against you shall prosper. If God is with you, no storm can take you out. God is with us. There's no burden too heavy to bear because God is with us.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. I believe it.
Amen.
I believe it. I receive it.
Yes.
And in the name of Jesus, I'm going to live it out.
Yes.
Let's give God some praise.
Yes.